Today we are here to celebrate Lucas and how bioengineering has influenced his life and changed his life so that we have turned a disability into a time to celebrate and so that he could be a celebrity actually in his school. So why are we here today? The reason we are here is that I teach a rehab engineering graduate course at UofL. In this course, or in rehab engineering, basically the students are exposed to medical aspects of disability. They learn about using a wheelchair. One of the exercises that they do is to actually go out into the community to understand the challenges that individuals with wheelchair, who are using wheelchairs, face on a day-to-day basis. And the other aspect of our course is that we learn about prosthetics. We go to Kentucky Prosthetics so that they can understand the fabrication process and how prosthetics are developed. The course project that we had this year was to use open source software that's available on from an Enable website for the design of a prosthetic hand. The students took the open source design and basically modified it so that it would be customized to the needs of Lucas. Lucas was unfortunately born with a disorder that's referred to symbrachydactyly, which is a condition whereas the hands or the fingers on the hand are sometimes not fully formed and the bones can be fused together. So what we have done is developed, the students have done, is basically to develop a prosthetic hand that is adaptable to Lucas's hand so that he is able to be more independent throughout his day and to be able to engage in the normal daily activities that many children do at the age of 6 years. So I'd like to introduce the folks that we have here today, our students from our bioengineering class, Alyssa Hoeper, and also Stephen Callahan. And then of course we have Lucas Abrahams and his father Eric and mom Rachel. And then his grandma, Julie, who started this whole process whenever she reached out to our bioengineering department to see if there was anything that we were able to do to help Lucas. So with that, what I'd like to do is to ask Stephen and Alyssa to share with you the various hands that they designed as a part of their class and to show you how they fit them to Lucas and tell you a little bit about the 3D printing process that they utilized in the design of their hand. Okay?
So these are some of the hands that we designed for Lucas. All of the components are mostly made from a 3D printer, which you can see over here. So what we did was we took the designs, made them into a 3D model on the computer, were able to fit it to his hand from 3D scanning, and then printed the components, and then were able to assemble them using different tendons and things, as well as leather components to adhere to his wrist and his palm. So pretty much his palm comes in here, and then when he bends his wrist, he's actually able to close his fingers. So this is one of the hands that we designed, as well as this one. We call this one the Spider-Man hand. And then this one over here as well, which is a glow-in-the-dark, made from PLA, which is kind of the material that Legos are made out of.
Prior to receiving the prosthetic hand, Lucas was unable to grasp a ball or to grasp a piece of paper, zip his jacket, and within minutes of receiving the prosthetic hand in the classroom, after a few adjustments, within 5 minutes, Lucas was able to pick up a ball and actually throw the ball and interact with the students. So I myself was actually even quite surprised. I didn't expect that it would be that quick that it would happen.
We're just grateful through this whole process how wonderful everyone's been. The students, Professor Gina, she's just been wonderful to work with, and we were just surprised at the difference between the three different robo hands. And initially we had met back in October and they did a casting and a 3D image of his hand so that they could get a really good fit of the prosthetic device, and that's what's been, I think, the most important part and him being able to use it as the fit of it. So we're just now kind of exploring and experimenting and seeing all the different things that we can do with it now, and he's had a lot of fun with it, so we're very grateful for that.
As bioengineers, any time that we're able to design and provide assistive technology to improve the independence and integration of someone who has a disability, we know that at the end of the day, our job is done. And in this case, for us, having Lucas with a smile on his face and being able to interact with his classmates, that really makes our day.